All right, we have arrived at crystal systems. What are crystal systems? Crystal systems are just the different shapes that are possible when you form matter together. The whole field's called crystallography, and it's the study of how these bits of matter come together in different ways. What sort of crystal systems have we seen so far? Well, we've seen cubic, right? Like body-centered cubic, diamond cubic, zinc blend. We've seen lots of examples of cubic. In all of these cases, what do they have in common? The edge length in the three directions, A1, A2, and A3, are all equal to each other. Otherwise, it wouldn't be a cube. It'd be like a rectangle, right? So if they're all equal to each other and the angles between all of these are 90 degrees, you're in the cubic system. What else have we seen? Well, in the case of hexagonal close-packed and wurtzite, we saw hexagonal systems, right? Hexagonal systems, we said, okay, A1 and A2 are equal to each other, but they are not equal to A3, right? A was short and then C was taller. It was a bigger number, right? Another thing is that the angle between A1 and A2 is 120 degrees. It's not 90 degrees, it's 120 degrees, right? But the angle between the second and the third axis and the first and the third axis are both 90 degrees. So A1 and A2 are 120 degrees from one another, but angle 3 is orthogonal to both, right? That's how you define the hexagonal system. And then we saw one other one with rutile, where we said that A and B are equal to each other. They're not equal to A3, sometimes called C. And this system is orthogonal, right? Meaning it's all 90 degrees, right? Well, those are just three of the seven crystal systems that are out there. Imagine this one, trigonal. Right, in trigonal, all of these sides are equal to one another, and all of the angles are equal to one another, but they are all less than 120 degrees. That will give you a shape like the one you see here in the trigonal crystal system. Or the orthorhombic system. In the orthorhombic system, everything is 90 degrees, so it's nice and squared up, it's orthogonal to each other, but they're all different lengths. You've got A, you've got B, and you've got C. Different lengths, right? And again, they're calling these A1, A2, A3. It's totally equivalent to call them ABC. A, B, C. In fact, I think it's even more common. You've got monoclinic, where none of those are equal to one another, and two of the angles are 90 degrees, but the third one is not 90 degrees. And then you've got triclinic, the lowest symmetry crystal system of all. None of the lengths are equal to each other, and none of the angles are equal to each other. So it's just pretty goofy out there, right? Those are the seven different crystal systems. Now, once you've got those seven crystal systems, you can combine those systems with a centering possibility. We talked about this before, like with body-centered cubic. If you put an atom in the center, here they're calling it volume-centered. It's also been called body-centered, right? So that's an example of a different Bravais lattice than simple cubic, where there's no centering, right? So when you start to count up these different, not only crystal systems, but the centering options possible with them, that gives you 14 Bravais lattices. The centering options are none, or simple, sometimes called primitive, that's why the P is there, volume-centered, or internal, base-centered, that's C, or face-centered, right? Now you might be wondering, well, what about, couldn't I do a face-centered tetragonal, right? So here's our tetragonal. Couldn't I do this? A is equal to B is not equal to C, right? Couldn't I do a face centering on this operation, right? Put some on the face, like so. If you do that, you'll find that it's actually not allowed because you can reduce this to a smaller unit, and they've done this here, they've shown it here. So take a look here at the lighter gray lines. I'm going to outline them in red. They started out with a face-centered tetragonal, but then they did this. Do you see the other unit cell forming there? It's an internal, right? It's a volume-centered tetragonal. It's actually smaller, so that's why this one actually just turns into that one. So it doesn't actually exist, okay? So those are the 14 Bravais lattices. You can count them up 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14, okay? Now, if you then add on to it all the unique symmetry operations that can exist for where atoms go, you end up with 230 different called space groups. And these are the unique space groups that can exist in matter. Okay, so those are crystal systems, Bravais lattices, and space groups. We're not going to talk a lot about space groups in this class. That really belongs in a course on crystallography. But for this class, it's enough to know that there are 7 crystal systems, and when you combine those with centering options, you end up with 14 Bravais lattices.